India Sierra Sierra, over. India Kilo 1 Sierra Lima Delta, I have you loud and clear. I am ready and glad to be with the school in Italy today. Watching the men landing on the moon, and that inspired me to become an astronaut. Over. I think my favorite would be, we have this dish called chicken strips and salsa, and I usually put that on a tortilla to make like a taco. However, we just had a vehicle show up a few days ago, and it had fresh fruit on board, so right now, apples and oranges are my favorite food, just because we haven't had them in so long. Over. Daytime, we do see Earth that's all lit up, but we also, if you look the other way, it's pure darkness. So in that sense, yeah, we do see more darkness. Now we have several more sunsets and sunrises every day, so if we're having to be looking out the window a lot throughout the day, we'll see a lot more darkness up here than you do on Earth. And we hadn't figured that one out yet. We don't have an actual shower here, but all we can do is wet down a washcloth or a towel and put a little liquid soap on it and kind of scrub ourselves down every day. Over. Well, you won't see the effects really while you're in space, but you will see them when you come back to Earth. And that's, you'll have bone density loss, bone mass loss, muscle mass loss, and your body in general just will not be in the shape it was when you came home. So exercise is extremely important for us. We do it 2 hours a day, every day while we're up here. Over. If we're looking out at the right time, we can see the same planets that you see from Earth. We're only about 400 kilometers closer than you are, so with planets being millions and millions of kilometers away, we're really not that much closer. So we do see them a little clearer because we don't have the atmosphere that you have to look through when you're on the Earth to see the planets. But in general, they look very much similar to they do on Earth. Over. Lately, I've been outside spacewalking a few times, and you do hear kind of a few creaks and things of the vehicle. The robotic arm, we did hear a little bit of that as it was moving around. Over. Now there's five right now, and they're all attached to the space station. There are two Soyuz, Russian Soyuz spacecraft, and that's the ones our crews flew up on. There's a Russian Progress vehicle, which is just a cargo ship. It's attached here as well. And we have a Japanese cargo vehicle, which just arrived 2 days ago, and that's attached. So including the space station, that's five vehicles right here. The Chinese also have a space station that's in orbit right now. And there's several other spaceships, maybe a handful, that are out looking at other planets like Mars and Jupiter. And satellite-wise, there are thousands of satellites, and they're way higher than we are, so they're not in our way, but I know there's quite a few out there. Over. Up on board the space station, we come up in groups of three because that's what the Soyuz, the Russian Soyuz spacecraft holds. So my group of three is myself and two cosmonauts from Russia. And the other crew is a Russian, an American, and a French astronaut. So right now we have six people on board, and most missions are around 5 to 6 months long. Spacewalking suits are very heavy, to answer your second question there. They weigh about 250. Still need someone to help us put them on because they're very bulky, and usually you get in and you need help of one or two other people. It's a thermal micrometeor garment, so it's to culminate in kind of the white part on the outside that you see when we're going out to do spacewalks. Over. Harmful contaminants out of the air, so we don't breathe those. Those kind of things are the most important, including things like the bathroom, which, you know, kind of sounds funny, but it's a very important piece of hardware up here, and if it's broken, then it's a big deal. While we're flying around, we don't use a whole lot of fuel. The only time we'll use fuel is if we're going to reorient ourselves, which happens every few months or so. If another vehicle is arriving, we sometimes have to reorient the space station, and we'll use a little bit of fuel, but in general, we do not use a lot. The orbit that we're in just kind of keeps us here, and that way we don't have to use a lot of fuel. Over.